Well, David Ige has no such close battle on his hand tonight for the Democratic representative to go on and be in the general election. We're going to check in with his headquarters to see now votes he is ahead of Governor Abercrombie. Jai?
Joe, I'm having a hard time hearing you because this place is exploding. It's the old varsity building, and it is absolutely pumping because the man of the hour is here, David Ige, who has absolutely run away with this governor's race. The last numbers, more than 110,000, almost 111,000 votes, 67% of the vote. That's to Mr. Abercrombie, Governor Abercrombie, the incumbent, just 50,792 votes. That's 67% to 31. I don't know if you can see the candidate or not because there are a ton of people in this room. And it really is a testament to how he has built this grassroots campaign. He is shaking hands right now, he and his family, with former Governor Ariyoshi, who had endorsed him, as well as Governor Cayetano, who had also endorsed him. The candidate is on stage, and if you can see him, I know the signs are going crazy and everything, but he's expected to address the crowd at any moment now. So we will, obviously, you can see him celebrating, and there's lots of signage. I would guess there's probably at least a couple of hundred people in here that are cheering for their man who has won this. Our understanding is very soon we could hear a concession speech out of the governor. But right now here is David Ige.
Thank you very much. I think we have lots to be encouraged about. I think the numbers are great, but it's still a little early. Let me just say a couple things. When we started this 13 months ago, I probably had more people tell me that I was crazy than really believing that this night could happen. I know that it's early, but it really has been heartwarming for me. You know, when we started 13 months ago, it was Dawn and Lauren and Matthew and Amy in our living room, dreaming about what might be able to happen 13 months from now. It really was a humbling beginning for us. You know, many asked why we were doing it, but we just felt like it was the right time. I did want to just thank all of the people all across the state who has joined us in supporting this campaign. There are still many votes to be counted, but I think we have a lot to be proud of. I did want to thank Will Okabe and HSTA. They have, they were the first and they were there from the very beginning and they were there at every single event. So thank you for teachers. I did want to also thank my father, who passed away several years ago, but he definitely instilled in me the belief that leadership is really walking the talk, and it's really more important what you do than what you say. And I've lived that for all of my years in the state capitol. Wanted to thank my mom, who was always my greatest supporter. You know, she couldn't be here tonight, but I will be visiting her tomorrow. And all of my brothers, you know, the Andagi tradition continues. They've been with the campaign every step of the way. For those of you who have ever run for office, you do know that it starts with friends and family first. I did also want to acknowledge a couple of elementary and middle school friends who, when we started this, didn't really know what they were getting into, but agreed to do it anyway. Keith Hiraoka, my campaign manager. And Gordon and Patty Arakawa. Gordon, I've known for 50, Arakaki, sorry. Who are working with the grassroots. They really, you know, we started this campaign believing in people and the people of Hawaii. And we knew that if we reached out and touched enough people, that we would have an opportunity to be successful. You know, there are many, many more votes to be counted, but it is so energizing to be here this evening amongst all of you. When we started this 13 months ago, no one thought that we would ever get anywhere close to where we are today. You know, we're two printouts in and there are many more votes to be counted, but I feel really good about where we're at. I did want to thank Governor Ariyoshi and Governor Cayetano for believing in me from the very first conversation. You know, the first time I met with Governor Ariyoshi, he said, the secret is coffee hours. coffee hours. And that's what we've been working on through the campaign. It really has been about coffee hours, about reaching and touching as many people as we can. I did want to say aloha to all of the neighbor islands. I'm sorry I didn't have a chance to talk to all of you on the neighbor islands. I just want to thank each and every one of you. You know, 13 months ago, we became very much aware that this isn't the state of Oahu, it's the state of Hawaii. And we learned very quickly that neighbor islands have different issues, but just as important issues. And I've learned so much. I want to thank all of the crew from the Big Island, Molokai, Maui, Lanai, Kauai, and Oahu for all of their time in helping us to get into each and every community and each and every living room. This has really been a marvelous campaign from the family perspective, from just the opportunity to get out and meet and talk with people. I also wanted to just thank the people of Hawaii for giving me the opportunity, for inviting me into their homes, into their community centers, into their businesses, to have a chance to sit down and talk story so that I could learn about Hawaii and about why this is such a special place for all of us. It really started this campaign. I've learned so much, and there is so much more to go. But this is a great start. Let's get through those third and fourth ballots. Thank you.